Taped live from the basement of a welding company in Hell's Kitchen, deep in the bowels of Manhattan, it's the 1990 Roundtable Awards. And now, here are your hosts, Andrea Lipinski and Keith Roundtable Awards DeCandido.
Thank you from the studio audience, and thank you, Hawk. We're back with a whole bunch of new episodes of The Chronic Rift, starting this evening with the 1990 Roundtable Awards. First, however, you may notice the person on my right is a new, different person on my right. This is our new host, Andrea Lipinski.
Thank you, Keith. I've been a big fan of this show for some time, and I'm glad that I actually get to co-host with someone like you.
Oh, shit. Anyway, before we start, we should let you know we have a new address. Don't send anything to 33 Highland Avenue anymore. Our new address is The Chronic Rift, P.O. Box 2224, New York, New York, 10185-0023. Send your love letters, your hate mail, your memorable moments, your ideas, and, of course, your free books and comic books. We especially like the free books and comic books. Anyway, the awards. These awards were not just chosen willy-nilly.
They were chosen by you, the viewers.
So don't blame us if you don't like the choices.
Tonight we feature as the nominees the ones that received the most votes. The ones that won were the ones that received the most of the most votes.
Of course. Just to make sure everything legit, the law firm of Crescenzo, Andreassi, Graziana, and Peters checked over everything to make sure it was right as our auditors.
And one final note, anything David Lynch produces is a fantasy.
So it counts. Anyway, our first presenters for the evening are Paula Araya and Ken Walker. Paula was a former director of the Rift and our makeup artist. Ken is a special effects artist who was on our discussion of special effects, appropriately enough. Come on up. They'll be presenting our first awards. Take it away.
Hello. I'm Ken. This is Paul.
Hi.
As we didn't.
For our first one, we're introducing best performers in a movie or TV series. Scott Bakula for Quantum Leap.
Danny Glover for Predator 2.
Angelica Houston for Witches.
Eric Pierpont for Alien Nation.
Patrick Stewart, Star Trek The Next Generation.
And the winner is...
The envelope. Hate these things.
No one has gotten into these envelopes. No one knows the winner.
Patrick Stewart, Star Trek The Next Generation.
One world's butcher is another world's hero. Perhaps I am neither one.
On what basis, Admiral, am I to decide? Your good word? Are you willing to help us overpower the Romulan B-type warbirds we may encounter? Are you prepared to help us detect them through their cloaking shields?
Accepting on behalf of Paramount Pictures are Johanna O'Brien and Joel Falco.
On behalf of Patrick and The Next Generation, just like to say thank you very much. Now we have the award for best writer of a comic book, novel, TV series, or movie.
Orson Scott Card, Maps in the Mirror.
Peter David, Star Trek The Next Generation. I'm sorry, Star Trek The Incredible Hulk.
Ooh. Neil Gaiman, The Sandman.
Ellen Kushner, Thomas the Rhymer.
Alan Moore, Big Numbers.
And the winner is, let's see what we have here, Hermetically Sealed. Keeps all in suspense.
Oh, yeah.
And the winner is Neil Gaiman for The Sandman. Thank you. We'll accept the award on behalf.
He heard long ago in a dream that one day in every century death takes on mortal flesh, better to comprehend what lives she takes must feel like, to taste the bitter tang of mortality, that this is the price she must pay for being the divider of the living from all that has gone before and all that must come after. He broods on this tale but has never questioned her about its truth. Perhaps he fears that she would answer him.
The next award is for Best Director of a Movie or TV Series. Kenneth Johnson, Alien Nation.
Paul Verhoeven for Total Recall.
Jerry Zucker for Ghost. Ooh, another envelope. Ooh, I can't
read. These are the heavy ones here.
Let's see who this is. Jerry Zucker for Ghost.
Okay, we don't have a clip for Ghost. So what we're going to do instead is have Andrea Lipinski and Orenthal Hawkins doing their rendition of the music from Ghost. Come on outside. Come on.
Yay! Oh, my love, my teddy bear.
Okay, okay, thank you. That's good. Thanks. Okay, let's go. Thank you.
And now, an award that is near and dear to my heart, Best Special Effects in a TV Series or Movie.
Okay, The Flash.
The Navigator.
Predator 2.
Star Trek The Next Generation.
And Total Recall.
And the winner is the most important award of all time.
Of course.
We have the winner right here. Star Trek The Next Generation, all right.
Actually, the award will be accepted by the team of Joe and Joe once again.
Yeah!
Oh, well.
Yeah! On behalf of Star Trek The Next Generation, I'd like to thank you, the audience, since you're the ones who voted for us, and because of you, we have now entered our fourth season, and very successfully. Thank you. Ooh, cute.
Thanks a lot, you guys.
Our next presenters are going to be Jo Duffy and Joe Pierce.
Joe and Joe, once again. Jo Duffy is a comics writer who appeared on our discussion of Doctor Who a while back, and Joe Pierce is a comics fan who was on our discussion of alternative comic books. They will be presenting the next four awards. Take it away, Joe and Joe. Come on up here.
Hi, I'm Joe.
And I'm Joe.
Okay, our first category that we're going to present is Best TV Series Episode. The first entry is The Best of Both Worlds, Part 1, Star Trek The Next Generation.
Also, The Best of Both Worlds, Part 2, Star Trek The Next Generation.
The Halloween Episode from The Simpsons.
Real Men from Alien Nation.
The Way Home from Quantum Leap. And
the round table goes to
The Best of Both Worlds, Part 1, Star Trek The Next Generation.
Sir, reading unidentified vessel just entering sensor range. Bearing 210, mark 151.
Hang on there, Mr. Wolf.
No response, sir.
Move to intercept.
Aye, sir.
Sir, the vessel has already changed course to intercept us. Approaching at warp 9.3. Entering visual range.
On screen. Magnify. Mr. Worf, dispatch a subspace message to Admiral Hanson. We have engaged the Borg.
Accepting the award from Joe and Joe is Joe and Joe.
Congratulations. Thank you.
I think if we have to accept any more of these awards, we're going to need a cargo bay to take them all back. Thank you.
Okay, the next roundtable is for the best movie, and the nominees are Arachnophobia,
Ghost,
Gremlins 2, The New Batch,
Solaris,
and Total Recall. And when we can get it out of the envelope, the winner is Total Recall.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cat. Where can I take you tonight?
Drive, drive.
Would you please repeat the destination?
Oh, anywhere, just go, go.
Please state a street and number.
Shit.
I'm not familiar with that address. Would you please repeat the destination?
The Aquatic Rift accepts this award on Total Recall's behalf.
Our next category is Best Novel.
And the nominees are Chernivog by C.J. Cherry,
The Dark Half by Stephen King,
Stranger in a Strange Land by Robert E. Heinlein, the restored version,
Tehanu by Ursula K. Le Guin,
and Tigana by Guy Gavriel Kay.
And our winner is The Dark Half by Stephen King.
Chatterton lifted his boot to butt his cigarette. He planned to put the stub in the cruiser's ashtray once it was dead. Maine State Police did not litter the driveways of the taxpayers, and when he looked up, the man with the skinned face was there, lurching slowly up the driveway. One hand waved slowly at him and Jack Eddings for help. The other was bent behind his back and looked broken. Chatterton almost had a heart attack. Jack, he shouted, and Eddings turned. His mouth dropped open. Help me, the man with the skinned face croaked. Chatterton and Eddings ran toward him. If they had lived, they might have told their fellow officers that they thought the man had been in a car crash or had been burned by an explosive backlash of gas or kerosene, or that he might have fallen face first into one of those pieces of farm machinery which decide every now and then to reach out and tomahawk their owners with their blades, choppers, or cruel whirling spokes. They might have told their fellow officers any of these things, but at that moment they were really thinking of nothing at all. Their minds had been sponged clean by horror.
Accepting this award will be Ken, Without Barbie.
Congratulations. On behalf of Stephen King, I accept this award. Thank you. It's a very good book. I enjoyed it a lot.
And it sponged a lot of our minds clean with horror. Okay, and our next roundtable is for the best comic book.
Alien Nation, The Spartans by Bill Spangler, writer, James Tucker, and Path Grow, artist.
Batman by a number of different writers and artists.
Kings in Disguise by James Vance, writer, and Dan Burr, artist.
The Sandman by Neil Gaiman and various artists.
Finally, Spider-Man by Todd McFarlane, writer and artist.
Actually, that's Paige Grow on Alien Nation and Todd McFarlane on Spider-Man.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. But I've got to work with these guys. They'll want me to get it right. But the winner is The Sandman by Neil Gaiman and various artists.
You have come then, Will Shakespeare. It is already. I wrote it just as you told me, Lord. It is the best that I have written to this date. I am sure that it is. So, we are here on your command, my lord, on Midsummer's Eve, by the Long Man of Wilmington. An odd choice of a place for us to perform. Odd? Wendell's Mound was a theater before your race came to this island. Before the Normans. Before the humans.
The Chronic Rift accepts this award on behalf of Neil Gaiman and his artists.
Thank you, Joe and Joe.
Thank you. Joe and Joe. Joe and Joe. And all kinds of Joes. We are overridden with Joes.
Oh, yes, we are.
Okay.
Our next presenters are Celeste Hotaling and Orenthal Hawkins.
Celeste was on when we discussed Robert Heinlein and was kind enough to come back for our solstice party. Orenthal also came back for our solstice party. He's been on whole bunches of times. He was on when we talked about science fiction TV shows that flopped. He was on when we talked about Peter David, and he has been kindly serving as our MC this evening.
And you will also notice that Orenthal Hawkins you will recognize from the fabulous singing debut earlier this evening.
Yes, of course. Anyway, come on up here, do the next two awards, and life will be good. Or at least, so.
Aren't you glad this isn't as long as the Grammys? First, for Best Chronic Rift Episode.
Frankenstein, the first SF novel.
Robert Heinlein.
Quantum Leap.
Special effects.
Or J.R.R. Tolkien.
Well, let's see. The Roundtable goes to...
No paper cuts, please.
Ouch. Why, it's Frankenstein, the first SF novel.
Produce Frankenstein movie the way Mary Shelley wrote it.
It would make a great movie.
Starting with a ship stuck in the ice, right? And this dog sled coming along with Frankenstein and ending with a monster running off into the distance.
Would you think, though, that anybody would see it, though?
Well, it would have to be on public television on six
hours. Oh, no, it'd be a sensation.
Well, it's a short enough novel, you could probably do it. And yeah, the scenes of Mont Blanc. I mean, those are really visual. The whole thing when he's sailing down the Arve before he meets the monster,
terrific.
He actually talks to the monster.
Yeah, but if you don't have Sting selling the movie, or you don't have right. Gene Wilder making it into a comedy, if you've got the real true.
You've got enough atrocities in that book to keep it going, you know. You've got a murdered kid. You've got
that,
you know,
what I'm trying to say, in terms of the way science...
The Chronic Rift. Flash. What a surprise. This is really great. I was... This episode was actually my idea to begin with my execution, and I was nervous as hell when we were doing it, as you may have noticed by all the lines I flubbed during Comic Art Commentary for that one. But I want to thank, right here on the air, physically, verbally, the three guests, Don Ryman, our Noble Shelley scholar, and Greg Cox, who came in as a last-minute replacement and was fantastic, but especially Emily Sunstein, who schlepped all the way up here from Philadelphia just to be on our show. And... I don't know, I was touched. Anyway, it went really well. I'm glad that everybody was willing to accept this, and I'm going on far too long here, so I will just give it back to frickin'
Brad. Yes,
get
up camera and shut up.
Thank you.
You didn't thank Mary Shelley. Okay, the next award is Best Character in a Movie, TV Series, Novel, or Comic Book.
Al, Quantum Leap.
Data from Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Dilbert, the exterminator from Arachnophobia.
Christine Gathercall from Big Numbers.
And CEO Mina Gladstone, The Fall of Hyperion.
Okay.
And this round table goes to...
Goes
boy,
to.
You did that well.
Okay.
Want me to sing again?
Ah, what a surprise. Data from Star Trek The Next Generation.
Have you any idea... What will happen when Starfleet learns about this?
I have followed all of Starfleet's regulations to the best of my ability. I expected they would be pleased.
Well, you have taken on quite a responsibility, Data.
To prepare, I have scanned all available literature on parenting. There seems to be much confusion on this issue. One traditional doctrine insists spare the rod and spoil the child, suggesting a punitive approach, while another more liberal attitude would allow the child enormous freedom Data. And what Klingons do to their children.
Data, I am not talking about parenting. I am talking about the extra.
Accepting on behalf of Star Trek The Next Generation are once again Jo and Jo.
Big surprise.
Oh, well, this is our fourth award. I'd just like to say once again, on behalf of Star Trek and Data, thank you very much. And keep watching.
Thank you, guys. Okay, we're sort of hogging the last one for ourselves. The last two, actually. Next one is...
What is the category?
Right there.
Best thing.
Thing.
Best thing.
Very general category.
Not like the movie, the thing. Just best thing.
Any old thing.
We're feeling abstract this evening.
All kinds of things.
Best thing of 1990.
Thing.
And the nominees are... Alienation... The Complete Alec Eddie Campbell.
No, it's The Complete Alec by Eddie Campbell.
The Complete Alec by Eddie Campbell.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Oh, all right. The Flash, that's the TV series, not the comic book. Gates McFadden.
She's a pretty cool thing.
Yes. Anyway, my personal favorite, William Shatner not directing a movie. wait.
There is more.
There is more. Tegana by Guy Gavriel Kay. And, remember we said anything by David Lynch counts as a fantasy? Well, Twin Peaks is a nominee for Best Thing of 1990. You want to open the envelope? I guess she wants to open the envelope.
That would be
lovely. Please open the envelope.
And the winner is Alien Nation.
I want this to happen. Promise me, George. Just try. Try to hold it in.
I can't. Undo my pants.
All right. Now what?
Place your hands here. Help me push.
George?
Push.
Okay, George, just hang in there, all right?
Now, put your fists against my temples. It helps dilate the pouch.
How's that?
It's coming.
Aquatic Rift accepts yet another award.
Actually, I'd like to dedicate this particular award to the Massachusetts supporters of Alien Nation who are trying to get the show back on the air. Anyway, last thing we'd like to do tonight is the Hall of Fame. Bruce Sterling is considered by some to be the spiritual father of cyberpunk, but William Gibson is definitely the eldest son who's done good. In 1984, Gibson published Neuromancer. This book combined pulp detective stories of the 1930s with the who-gives-a-damn sensibility of the punk movement of the 1970s, the video game craze of the 1980s, plus a good old-fashioned extrapolation of modern technology that science fiction authors love so well. The book was incredibly influential. A lot of young authors proceeded to write in the cyberpunk subgenre of science fiction that Gibson popularized in Neuromancer. It also inspired two sequels that came out in subsequent years, Count Zero and Mona Lisa Overdrive. Gibson has also been made fun of quite a bit, from Harry Harrison's Dr. Cy Burpunk in his Build the Galactic Hero books to the cyberpuke people in Dan Simmons' Hyperion and Fall of Hyperion books. Gibson's latest work is with his spiritual father, Sterling, in a book that's coming out this month, March of 1991, called The Difference Engine, which will deal with an England in which computer technology actually exists in the 19th century, and the England is under Prime Minister Byron. Anyway, this most influential of cyberpunk authors couldn't be with us here tonight to accept the award because he lives in Vancouver and we don't. So, on his behalf is the person William Gibson calls the hippest SF writer in New York, the author of the new book Heathens, Mr. Jack Womack. Have an award.
On behalf of William Gibson, many thanks, much appreciation, and best of luck to the Chronic Rift. Thank you.
Oh, that seems to be it. We're plumb out of stuff.
That's it?
Okay, we have a couple of... Yes, that's it.
Oh, okay.
You don't want it?
No.
Okay.
I mean,
we ran out of awards. Nobody voted for anything else.
Well, okay.
Yeah. Anyway, thought I'd let you know what's coming up over the next few weeks. We are going to be doing next week's Science Facts in Science Fiction. We'll be having a couple of authors, Ben Bova and Charles Platt, for that one. Mm-hmm. After that, we'll be doing Beauty and the Beast, including Stephanie Wiltsey, who is the editor of Pipelines, so Beauty and the Beast fan magazine, and Wendy Peeney, who did the graphic novel version for First Publishing.
Can we talk about the movie, too?
Huh?
Can we talk about the movie?
The movie?
The French movie.
No.
We're
talking about Ron Perlman and Linda Hamilton getting pregnant and shot.
We can compare it.
We could.
You know, to add some depth to the discussion, maybe. Maybe a little culture.
Culture?
Culture.
On the Chronic Rift? Are you out of your mind?
Yes, a little culture.
Well, maybe.
Just because I've seen it and you haven't.
That's true. I'm jealous. Anyway, what are we doing next? Next, we're doing the works of Ursula K. Le Guin, author of Tehanu, the Earthsea series, Left Hand of Darkness, all kinds of neat stuff. Authors Patricia Keneally will be on the show, as well as editor James Frankel and critic Don Keller. You may remember Jim Frankel from our Women in Science Fiction discussion. And after that, oh yeah, by the way, Patricia Keneally is the Patricia Keneally, the one who married Jim Morrison and is in the movie with the Oliver Stone movie that just came out. And yes, she's going to be on our show. Ain't we something?
We're on the cutting edge, Keith.
We are. Jo Duffy, whom you saw a little while ago, will be on our Japanese animation show, which will be the next week, in addition to our logo designer, Felix Rodriguez, and a player to be named later. After that, we are doing Getting Your Fantasy and Science Fiction Published. Yes, I have to look at her in order to remember things. She's my muse. That will have Omni editor Ellen Datlow and somebody else.
Somebody else.
Yes. Oh, Laurie Perkins, an agent, as well as another player to be named later. We'll be doing a show on Blake 7. Celeste, whom you saw up here before, will be on that one, as well as a couple of people who've written about the show, Joe Nazzaro and Tom Beck. And I'm sure you're all bored to tears at this point. And the last, not the last show, but one other show we're doing is an interview show. This is going to be a special, different thing. We're going to do a different format. And
We're into these different formats.
Yeah, we are. I mean, look at tonight.
You had your Christmas show. You had this. You get the blue velvet dress with this tie. I don't know. This show is
getting too
different.
What's wrong with my tie? Wait a minute, what's wrong with my tie?
It doesn't go, Keith.
Anyway, the interviews will be with author Tom Dish, artist Tim Hildebrandt, and comics editor Andrew Helfer. And she's holding the tie. I love this. Anyway, next week will be Science Fact, and we'll see you then. Right?
Right.
Right. Good night.
This episode was sponsored in part by Tor Books, a publisher of fantasy and science fiction books available at your local bookstore, including White Jenna by Jane Yolen, and The Red Tape War by Jack L. Chalker, Mike Resnick, and George Alec Effinger, both now available, as well as the upcoming Xenocide by Orson Scott Card.